Adriana.
Morocco's destined to be a champion. There's no question in my mind. He's been a champion before. He'll be a champion again. He's that type of individual. Has all the tools necessary.
I am certain also, Gorilla Monsoon, that with Mr. Fuji as his now manager, that is going to have a very profound effect on this man's professional wrestling career.
Well, it certainly does. And not only nice maneuver. Look at this. He's going to get slammed again. Wow, he was driven right down into the canvas, and he's bailing out.
You know, you talk about lower back pain and injuries to the lower back that stick with you for the rest of your life. There's a couple of tremendous body slams on the part of Sweet Hansen to the magnificent Morocco that I'm certain are going to stay with him physically, at least, if not mentally, for a long, long time.
Absolutely.
To come.
Absolutely. Well, that's one of the reasons that Morocco's been out of the World Wrestling Federation. He's been in Hawaii recovering from just such an injury. And welcome back. But he's a tough customer. Notice he's not complaining. He didn't complain to the referee or anything. He's a trooper.
Backed up into the ropes.
Sweet never took his eye off him for a moment.
Why is Morocco doing that?
Well, he's going to try to get to this big guy one way or another. And if he can do it psychologically, that's the easier of two or three different ways that I know of.
Quite an antagonist, Mr. Morocco.
Yes, he is. But he respects his opponents.
Mr. Fuji sharing a few words with members of the Japanese press corps in attendance this week in his native tongue. And now he starts to spout a few directions or instructions.
There he is, the master of the martial arts.
Samurai War.
What a shot by Morocco. Another beauty.
A series of reverse knife edges on the part of Don Morocco. Sweet Hansen into that top turnbuckle.
Sweet blocked it. Oh. Whoa, listen to that. Smack of the flesh.
Look at him on load.
Another one. Oh. I felt that.
Gotta be kidding me. On their feet.
Fuji wasted no time getting around the corner post there to get a few words in with Morocco.
I want to see if I can pick up. Well, now he's all of a sudden, the minute I mention that, Fuji.
He quit.
Put the silencer on.
Yeah. Look at the look of intensity on the face of the Sweeter. These guys are certainly giving this ring a test, I'll tell you that.
Veteran Sweet Hansen. To challenge the magnificent Morocco. Thousands looking on from Madison Square Garden.
Beach Bum is the champ that's gone up.
Oh, that doesn't go over very big with Morocco. Referee Dick Crawl doesn't know what to make of it either.
Morocco hates that with a passion, Jim. Oh, break of the eyes stops the big guy momentarily. Morocco now with an arm whip. Holy mackerel, the ring just moved 4 inches and Morocco came head first into the corner, but the Sweeter was already gone.
You know, they've got Morocco listed at 247.
No way.
Gorilla Monsoon.
No way.
I would have to say that weight is
265 or 270 minimum.
Very
lighter than I saw him several months ago.
Oh, well, that food that he was enjoying in some of the clips that I saw from Hawaii seemed to me like he was eating very good.
Oh, no question about that. He does all the time.
And his social life was certainly not hurting either.
No, he's always got a bevy of beauties around him, Jane.
How sweet they are.
You and I have never been accused of that or resemble that remark in any way.
Well, I've had a few of them hanging on me every now and then. Been because they're too old to stand on their own 2 feet.
Oh my God, I love it.
Please.
Sweet, hanging on to this arm ringer in Morocco.
Hey, look, he is tippy-toeing.
Yes, he is. He's in a lot of pain. When you've got biceps and triceps that big, that's that much more pain. Now he's chicken winged it from behind and picking him right up.
That has got to be painful. Oh, that has got to be painful.
sweeter and giving Morocco all he wants right now. Now he's stomping with those size 14 and a halves.
And look at that. Look at that.
Stepping right on the fingers.
He has just prudently placed that boot on the left hand, which is turned up, by the way. Oh, my. On the magnificent Morocco.
Fingers are already beat up pretty badly on the right hand. Sweden now going to stay on that left arm and shoulder.
And also on that wrist, don't forget. He can move into a top wrist lock in a big hurry.
Well, the Swede's got a great bear hug in his repertoire. Why he's not using it at this point, I don't know. He's already softened up that back pretty good, Gene.
I would have to say so with numerous.
Of course, I'm sure there's a lot of things going through the Swede's mind right now. It's easy for us to be.
Well, you can't. We can't sit here and second guess anybody. Stop. Really working on that. I think that come into play.
That's another weak spot of Morocco's, and the Swede knows it. He had his shoulder operated on here 3 or 4 years ago. Look at Fuji shouting the words of encouragement and instruction to Morocco. That's like having a handicap match with him at ringside. You got to keep an eye on him because you never know what the guy's going to do.
You know, he is not above throwing his own 2 cents worth into this matchup either.
Absolutely not. You know, he's always got to.
It wouldn't be the first time that he interfered.
Definitely not.
Look at Morocco.
With a series of knees into the lower abdomen, slowed the big guy down. Morocco didn't have much choice. He had to resort to something.
He really went downstairs on the last one. Follows up with a boot and Swede Hansen draped over that second rope.
Very good, very good.
The referee, Dick Crawl, is asking Morocco to back off.
Snap there. Sort of rolled him over. He couldn't get him over the top.
Like asking your mother-in-law not to show up.
Oh, look at this. That's one of Fuji's moves right there. The kamikaze drop.
That is right out of Fuji's book. And he wrote it.
Turns and bows to Mr. Fuji, saying that one's for you, brother.
Very good, very good.
Morocco with his own patented knee drop right across the lower sternum area. This is where the Swede is most vulnerable when he's down, when he's off his feet.
I can't believe that Morocco has got feeling back in that left arm after the punishment that it took earlier on in this particular bout.
Well, Gene, I've been watching this guy for a long time, and I've yet to come across another individual in professional wrestling who can take punishment like Morocco can and still come back. He's demonstrated that so many times. I thought he was down and out and ended up getting his hand raised.
Series of double chops to the throat. There's one to the side of the neck. A little bit of that martial arts.
Yes, it is.
He has really taken a page or two out of Mr. Fuji's book. Elbow to the top of the dome. I don't know if that did a whole lot.
That's a mistake.
Why?
That's a mistake right there. Swede has got a hard noggin. Morocco just found that out. Look out.
Boom.
Oh, look, he wouldn't let him drop. He said, I got other things in store for you, my friend.
Again! Boom!
Oh, he grabbed it again!
And listen to this crowd fire up! Oh, my! Hansen threatens!
3 times, and will he let him drop? Yes! Scooped him up!
Well, Morocco is just about got to be totally out of it.
Look out, Swede off the ropes. He got caught! He couldn't hold him! Opportunity there for the Swede, and Morocco scoop slammed him, but he couldn't hold a big guy. Oh, what a shot.
Reverse knife edge. That drops Morocco like a bad habit.
Swede's going to send him in again here.
Into the ropes.
Another scoop slam. No, Morocco around the corner. Drop kicked him right in the kidney. Head first, right into the turnbuckle.
Fuji is smiling, and Morocco is turning it on.
Look out.
Watch this. What a seesaw battle between Swede Hansen And the magnificent one, Don Morocco, gets the Duke in that exciting matchup here on the World Wrestling Federation from Madison Square Garden. By the way, as you very well know, Don Morocco, currently managed by Mr. Fuji. Fuji also having Jim the Anvil Neidhart in his stable. Fuji, of course, is going to have certainly quite an effect on the careers of these men. Fans, stay tuned. There's more exciting action coming up in the barbecue.
The World Wrestling Federation coming to these great areas and facilities with exciting mat action. Thursday, February 28th, Fresno, California, Fresno Convention Center. Friday, March 1st, Dayton, Ohio, Hara Arena. Friday, March 1st, Phoenix, Arizona, Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Saturday, March 2nd, Baltimore, Maryland, Baltimore Civic Center. Saturday, March 2nd, Boston, Massachusetts, Boston Garden. Sunday, March 3rd, Salisbury, Maryland, Wicomico Youth and Civic Center. Monday, March 4th, Peoria, Illinois, Peoria Civic Center. Wednesday, March 6th, Elizabeth, New Jersey, Dunn Recreation Center. Thursday, March 7th, Struthers, Ohio, Struthers Fieldhouse. Friday, March 8th, Uniondale, Long Island, New York, Nassau Coliseum. Saturday, March 9th, New Haven, Connecticut, New Haven Coliseum. The World Wrestling Federation on tour with great action for you.
If you're an investor, here's an important telephone number from Charles Schwab and an important message.
I work long hours at my job, but I still don't need somebody else telling me what stocks to buy and sell. I make my own decisions, and often I make them after the markets have closed. That's one reason I trade with Charles Schwab, the number one discount broker. With Schwab, I can place an order to buy or sell anytime, day or night, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And I can sleep easy. I know my order will be entered the minute the market opens. And I can save up to 76% on commissions compared to what full commission brokers charge. 24-hour service, big savings. That's why I invest through Charles Schwab.
I'm Charles Schwab. You'll like our low commissions, our convenience, and our quality service. That's a promise.
For a free booklet telling what Schwab Discount Brokerage can do for you, call 800-458-6400 toll-free. That's 800-458-6400. Charles Schwab, a Bank America company. Member SIPC.
Back to the World Wrestling Federation Sports Control Center. I think you can clearly see the tremendous influence that various managers within the ranks of the World Wrestling Federation are having on this great sport. For instance, Bobby the Brain Heenan on the careers of Ken Patera and Big John Studd. Most assuredly, Mr. Fuji on the career of one Don Morocco. And Fred Blassie on the careers of the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkoff. Blackjack Mulligan, take it away.
Welcome once again to Mulligan's Barbecue. And it just seems to be one of those weeks where your things don't go right. But first of all, I want to say all the folks out there that have been riding to the ranch house, Uncle Red is just full of mail. He can't handle anymore. Get your pens and your pencils ready, because at the end of the program, we're going to show you where you can ride in the United States and the Canadian addresses. And I got to say, this is a very distasteful moment for me. But Freddie Blassie, what are these guys going to do? What are you going to do with these people?
Well, it's not too happy about us either. And as far as these pessimistic geeks writing letters, they don't even know how to write.
I have something for you, Mr. Texas man. You know yourself, 80% of oil come to your country for a Persian gun. You are a prejudice, and recently you know that you American funds, they come...
Wait a minute. We really don't care if you turn our oil or gas off or not, if you want to know something, you creep.
Yeah. Exactly, we don't care about you either. Now, just a minute. That you American funds, Barry Mando and Marco Chando recently come to World Tag Team Championship.
What do you got to say, Rusky? What do you got to say, you commie rat?
So one of these my friends say, the two American funds, Barry Mando and Marco Chando, they don't deserve the belt. They stole the belt.
But it doesn't make any difference. They are the champions. You know something, Blassie, that amazes me? You're American-born, American-bred. How can you condone this communist bunch of crap out here?
Because I like to be associated with winners. And that's what these two fellas are. These are the uncrowned World Tag Team Champions. And the first time they get those two pencil-neck geeks in a ring, Barry Windham and Mike Rotunda, they will relieve them of that title.
Well, folks, I got to say goodbye. It's starting to get a little deep. It's starting to get deep here. I got to say goodnight for this week. God bless you. Keep the cards and letters coming right now. We'll see y'all next week. All right.
Well, I'll tell you, Blackjack Mulligan, perhaps not the most gracious host in the barbecue, and he certainly shot the poor Iron Sheik through the grease, saying he didn't care whether or not they turned off the oil to the United States. And Nikolai Volkoff, I don't know what he makes of Mr. Mulligan. Fred Blassie, of course, the man who is guiding Volkoff and the Iron Sheik in their respective careers, and certainly as a tag team combination. Fans, stay tuned. We're going to be right back with more exciting action.
Do you know anyone who eats grapefruit that doesn't lose weight?
Grapefruit 45 and a fat-burning plan that won't let you down.
I lose up to a pound a day. The Grapefruit 45 plan keeps me full.
Yes, you can actually eat delicious foods and still lose pound after pound quickly and safely.
Apparently, the secret's in the Grapefruit 45 plan, which helps speed up the fat-burning process.
There's no way I'd eat grapefruit three times a day.
30 pounds in just over 30 days.
There's no way I'm eating grapefruit for lunch. This little fat burner plan does the trick.
Grapefruit 45 diet.
Fat burner.
What would you rather have three times a day, this or this?
The Grapefruit 45 plan and our guarantee to lose weight fast without going hungry or your money back.
There has never been anything like a Grapefruit 45 weight loss plan. You'll burn off pounds of unwanted fat and get our money back guarantee. To save COD fees, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-453-8505 or send $19.95 to Fat Burner, Box 15, Carlsbad, California, 92008.
Tonto has ordered well over 1 million pieces of jewelry, and to show you that we mean business, we'll send you 3 Tonto diamond rings, a matching Tonto diamond pendant and chain, plus matching Tonto diamond earrings, plus 2 Tonto gold charms, plus 2 Tonto gold chains, all for the incredible low, low price of only $19.95 when you call this special test number now within the next 16 and a half minutes. As you can see, with well below wholesale bargains like these, you know that the Tonto Wholesale Jewelry and Gift Catalog that's included with your order will also be loaded with spectacular bargains. Plus, you receive this one-year computer-coded buyer's card, plus this credit card already approved for $100 credit limit and ready to use the minute you receive it. Remember, you receive not one, but three Tonto diamond rings, a matching Tonto diamond pendant and chain, plus these matching Tonto diamond earrings, plus two Tonto gold charms, plus two Tonto gold chains, plus this amazing wholesale bargain catalog, buyers and credit cards, plus your $100 credit limit, all for only $19.95. Try everything for 30 days, be 100% satisfied, or return everything for full refund, but you keep the three Tonto diamond rings free.
So call 1-800-228-3888 or send $19.95 plus $3 shipping to Big Deal, Box 545, Gambrills, Maryland. That's 1-800-228-3888.
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be a tag team match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Nice, France, weighing 235 pounds, the number one Frenchman, René Goulet. His partner, weighing 265 pounds, Moondog Rex. I'd like to introduce the manager, Captain Louis Albano. Now introducing the World Tag Team Champion. First from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 245 pounds, Barry Windham. Now introducing his partner champion from Syracuse, New York, weighing 245 pounds, Mike Rotundo.
Listen to the crowd. The new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the U.S. Express. You gotta go with them, Jesse. You gotta go with these tremendous stars in the world of professional wrestling. The combination of Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo.
Well, let me tell you something, Jack. I feel that it was definitely an upset when these two defeated Dick Murdoch and Adrian Adonis. Definitely an upset. But upsets do happen. They do happen. And now we'll have to wait and see what kind of a true tag team champions Windham and Rotundo are. They still got to prove something to me, Jack.
Their manager, Captain Lou Albano at ringside. It's René Goulet, the French star, going against Mike Rotundo. Moondog Rex, Goulet's partner, waiting in the wings.
And the action's fast, big arm drag by Rotundo. And you know, it's kind of unique now to see Captain Lou Albano being cheered. I can't handle that too well. seeing an ugly dude like Lou Albano getting cheered.
Captain Lou has seen the light, Jesse. He has seen the light, he has changed his ways, and has decided to go the straight path.
Well, it remains to be seen, in my opinion, after some of the things I've seen Captain Lou Albano do. There's a collar elbow hook up by Rex and Barry Windham. He blocked the punch, and Windham comes back with a headlock. Tags Rotundo. Rotundo into the ring. Kick to the stomach and to the headlock. Good teamwork. Good teamwork. I'll give him that.
You know, somewhere along the way, I don't know why, maybe it was a gut feeling on my part. Maybe it was, you get those feelings every now and then. But several months ago, I had the feeling that this combination of Mike Rotundo and Barry Windham someday would be the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
Well, you could see Rex caught him with a knee to the stomach, and now Rotundo's rocking and reeling, tag off to Goulet, and Goulet comes in hammering. Kicks Rotundo up, body slam. Now you notice, they're keeping Rotundo in their corner. That's a good move in tag team wrestling. Keep your opponent in your corner.
Well, Rene Goulet, who has been in tag team competition many, many times, he's a crafty veteran, and he's working with the big, strong man, Moondog Rex.
And they're keeping Rotundo in the corner, and Rotundo's in trouble. He's young, and he got caught in the corner. Oh, and clotheslined him right on that top rope. That'll snap a man's neck.
Right now, Mike Rotundo taking quite a pasting from the combination of Rene Goulet and Moondog Rex.
Rex is in there, and a big right hand to the jaw. And here comes Goulet, drops an elbow. Goulet and Rex are teaming up real well, double-teaming Rotundo right now. Another shot to the jaw.
Barry Windham helpless right now, unable to do anything. And Captain Lou Albano complaining about referee Terry Yorkston.
Well, Rex and Goulet are doing a terrific job double-teaming right here. Double clothesline, and down goes Rotundo. The new champions are taking some heavies tonight.
There's a kick out by Mike Rotundo, reaching back for something extra that time.
Goulet with a snapmare takes him over and goes to a claw hold. Rene Goulet with a claw hold on Mike Rotundo, squeezing in on those temples.
That's the French claw hold, as Goulet calls it.
Moondog Rex coming in and dropping a big elbow to the abdominal region. Rotundo trying to tag and makes the tag. And a beautiful sunset flip. And he got him. What a move by Barry Windham.
Unbelievable. Did you see that? Oh, we got to take another look at that one. That comes out of nowhere. Absolutely nowhere. What a tremendous victory by the newly crowned World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. The combination of Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo. All right, let's get the official decision.
The winners of the match, the World Tag Team Champions, Mike Rotundo and Barry Windham.
Oh, there they are, along with Captain Lou Albano, their new manager, Jesse. Quite impressive.
Well, I'll tell you something. That was an impressive move by Barry Windham. But in all honesty, Jack, I thought that Goulet and Moondog Rex had the upper hand for about 70% of this match. Here you see Windham going up. It's a phenomenal sunset flip off the top rope. Unbelievable. Look at that.
Look at that.
Catches him by the waist, tucks his head, pulls Rex over, gets him off balance, hooks the shoulders. One, two, and the three count. He got him.
Moondog Rex never knew what happened. It happened so quickly with Windham coming off of that ring rope with that sunset flip, catching Moondog Rex just perfectly. Never knew what happened.
Well, I'll tell you though, the champions took a beating in that match.
All right, more exciting World Wrestling Federation action right after this interview.
they say all kinds of things, but they're afraid to really come and say it to my face. I sit here with my back to you because I figured possibly somebody out there would at least like a chance. Hulk Hogan said something about it's the size of the fight and the dog. I ain't never been compared to no dog.
I don't come from no dog. They says, you kick Cyndi Lauper, and how could you kick a woman? I says, you know, I'm an equal opportunist. That, you know, woman hits me, I'll knock her out. It doesn't matter to me. He says, you took that poor old fat slob Lou Albano, the captain. Remember the little tidy bowl, man? I got a job. I got a little ship for you, captain. Remember in the bowl where the boat used to go around? I'm supposed to feel bad because I kicked accidentally this woman that grabbed a hold of me, and I nail this big fat slob who has been calling you all kinds of names for years, and now because he does something good for muscular dystrophy, everybody's behind him. And then I look over and this skinny little geek, this skinny little guy, who's Wendy or Cyndi Lauper, whatever her name is, her boyfriend, whatever she is. I took him and I power slammed him, and here comes New York's finest in Madison Square Garden. Policemen turn in their badges when I come to town. And I look over and I see that Jimmy Snuka, he can't run down, you see, because my bodyguard, Ace is there. I love my bodyguard. And Ace has got all kinds of weapons in his hand. He's got chairs. And he's watching my back. And all of a sudden, I see Dick Clark. And Dick Clark comes and takes two steps towards me. Like he thought he was going to do something to me. Him selling all them facial products. Can you imagine him do something to Hot Rod himself, Roddy Piper? The only thing you'd be good for after that is maybe playing the organ deep down in some opera house. You remember the Phantom of the Opera? The one with the face all twisted around. And they say, Roddy, how could you be so bad? And I say, you know, even at my worst, I'm best. And while my bodyguard is doing his job and he's keeping Jimmy Snuka, the super fly, away, legend of wrestling. In sneak, Hulk Hogan. Like he's going to do something to me, huh? In sneaks Hulk Hogan in all his glory. But did you notice when he come in and he looked eye to eye, all of a sudden he stopped just for a moment. Because he really wasn't sure whether he should come or not. I don't blame you. I am the legend killer. If you're drowning in a river, I'm the kind of guy that'll throw you a rope. But I'll throw you both ends.
Order a subscription to the official WWF magazine and save. For only $14.47, you receive 8 issues with feature stories on the stars of WWF, full-color pictures, highlights of past ring performance, great action shots, and more. Save nearly 20% by ordering your subscription now. To order, send check or money order for $14.47 or your Visa MasterCard number and expiration date to official WWF magazine, P.O. Box 20500, Bergenfield, New Jersey, 07621.
Be ready in half an hour?
Almost ready.
Gentlemen, I think you're going to have to agree with me. It has been one exciting hour, and especially that seesaw battle from Madison Square Garden between the magnificent Morocco and Swede Hansen. Morocco, that time out, of course, getting the Duke. And, of course, we have seen the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo, of course, continuing their winning ways. A big one next week here on All-American Wrestling. The tandem of Tony Atlas and the Junkyard Dog to meet Terry Gibbs and Carl Fury. A very special update. And the spoiler is also going to be on hand. Feature match, Bret Hart to meet the veteran Rene Goulet in Piper's Pit, Jim the Anvil Neidhart and Mr. Fuji, and also Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik as the tag team to meet Tony Garea and Aldo Moreno. Another reminder, this coming Tuesday night, Primetime Wrestling with Jack Reynolds and Jesse the Body Ventura. Friday night, TNT with Vince McMahon and Lord Alfred Hayes. Their guests will be none other than the Hillbilly Jim, along with his granny, no less. In addition, Swede Hansen, also a special guest this Friday night on TNT here on the USA Network. You'll be seeing Barry Windham, Mike Rotundo, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and his manager, Mr. Fuji. From the World Wrestling Federation Sports Control Center,